Ever wondered what a MAC address is and why it's crucial in networking? Curious about how they work and how to find yours? If so, this is the right video for you. Welcome to Whiteboard Doodles, the channel where we simplify tech-related concepts using whiteboard animations. Today, we'll break down the basics of MAC addresses. By the end, you'll have a clear understanding of their role and importance in networking. Let's get started. First, let's briefly examine what a MAC address is. A MAC address, or Media Access Control Address, serves as a unique identifier for devices on a network. Think of it as a distinctive ID badge assigned to each network device, such as a computer or smartphone. This 48-bit address, often written in hexadecimal format like this, ensures that every device can be accurately identified and communicated with within a local network. Just as an ID badge helps identify individuals in a large organization, a MAC address enables network devices to send and receive data efficiently, ensuring it reaches the correct destination. Now let's take a look at the differences between a MAC and an IP address. MAC addresses and IP addresses both play crucial roles in networking, but they serve different purposes. A MAC address is a unique identifier assigned to each network device by its manufacturer. It remains constant and is used to ensure that data packets reach the correct device within a local network. On the other hand, an IP address, or Internet Protocol Address, is assigned to devices to identify them on a broader network like the Internet. Unlike MAC addresses, IP addresses can change depending on the network a device is connected to, and they help route data across various networks. Essentially, while MAC addresses act like permanent, internal identification tags, IP addresses function as dynamic addresses that facilitate communication between devices over different networks. If you want to learn more about IP addresses, feel free to check out our video on the topic in the description below. Next, let's take a look at the structure of a typical MAC address. A MAC address is a 48-bit identifier typically formatted as 6 groups of 2 hexadecimal digits, separated by colons or dashes. This address is divided into 2 main components. The first 24 bits, known as the Organizationally Unique Identifier, OUI, are assigned to the device's manufacturer. The OUI allows for the identification of the manufacturer and ensures that all devices produced by that manufacturer have a consistent prefix. The remaining 24 bits are the Network Interface Controller, NIC, specific part, which provides a unique identifier for each device within the manufacturer's range. This combination of OUI and NIC specific bits ensures that every network device has a unique MAC address, facilitating precise identification and reliable communication within a local network. Now let's quickly take a look at how to find your MAC address on various systems. On Windows, open the command prompt by typing cmd in the search box and then enter ipconfig/all. This command will display detailed information about your system. Look for the physical address under your network adapter. This is your MAC address. On macOS, click the Apple menu and select System Preferences, then go to Network. Choose your active network connection and click Advanced. In the Hardware tab, you'll see the MAC address listed as MAC address or Wi-Fi address. Lastly, on Linux, open the terminal window and type ifconfig or iplink and press Enter. The MAC address will be listed in your network interface information next to HW address or link/ether. Now let's talk about security considerations. When considering security for MAC addresses, it's important to be aware of their potential vulnerabilities. Although MAC addresses are unique to each device, they can be spoofed by attackers to impersonate legitimate devices and gain unauthorized access to a network. To mitigate this risk, employ network access controls that restrict which devices can connect based on their MAC addresses and use encryption protocols to secure data in transit. Regularly update your network equipment and implement robust authentication mechanisms to further protect against unauthorized access. Additionally, consider using MAC address filtering combined with other security measures to enhance your network's overall security posture. For more information on common cyberattacks and how to defend against them, be sure to watch our detailed video linked in the description below. Now, let's discuss the process of changing a MAC address. Changing a MAC address, though it might seem counterintuitive since MAC addresses are typically hard-coded into a network interface card, NIC, and designed to be unique and unchangeable, is indeed possible. A network interface card is a hardware component that connects a computer to a network and includes a unique MAC address for identification. This flexibility to change your MAC address arises because many modern network interfaces and operating systems allow for a temporary alteration of the MAC address, often for privacy reasons or to troubleshoot network issues. The MAC address is embedded in the NIC's hardware, but operating systems can override this default value at a software level. This change is generally only temporary and will revert to the original hardware address upon reboot. Despite the ability to change MAC addresses, it's important to use this feature responsibly, as improper use can lead to network conflicts or breaches of network policies. In conclusion, MAC addresses are fundamental to networking, serving as unique identifiers for devices within a local network. They play a crucial role in ensuring that data packets are correctly delivered to the intended recipient by linking each device to its network interface card. While MAC addresses are typically hard-coded and unique to each device, their flexibility allows for temporary changes, which can be useful for privacy or network management. Despite their importance, MAC addresses are not without vulnerabilities, such as potential spoofing risks. By understanding their structure, purpose, and the implications of their use, you can better appreciate their role in network communication and the importance of managing them responsibly. This concludes our exploration of MAC addresses. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to also check out our other videos on related topics. Thank you for watching.